So to the playoff bracket, Bears are done. A 61-51 loss to the Detroit Lions, who move on to face the Atlanta Falcons. The 7-seed Eagles beat the defending champions in the wild card round and move on to face the 1-seed San Francisco 49ers. Over on the AFC side, the Chiefs is the 2-seed one. Ravens with a 20-10 win as the 6-seed over the 3-seed Patriots. And the 5-seed Bills beat the 4-seed Bengals 35-21. Conference championship weekend, it was the Eagles on a miraculous run. They've knocked off the 1-seed and the 2-seed on their way to the conference championship. And the Lions, man, if we were going to lose to the Lions like that, you'd think they'd at least go and win a Super Bowl for us. Fuck. But they lose by 3 to Atlanta. So it's 3-7 on the NFC side. The Baltimore Ravens knock off the 1-seed Colts, so both 1-seeds and 2-seeds done, as the Chiefs lose to the Buffalo Bills. So it's the 5-6 in the AFC. Bills and Ravens. What the hell? We get to take a look at the Pro Bowl roster. We should have some players here. Quarterbacks, Caleb Williams did not make it, actually. It's Dak, Desmond Ridder, and Brock Purdy. No running backs. Cole Kmet makes a Pro Bowl, so there's one. We might not actually get many Pro Bowlers. Just one right now in Cole Kmet. Eddie Jackson, there's a second. Jaquan Brisker, there's a third. So three Pro Bowlers for the Bears in the 2025 season. And to the playoff bracket, the Super Bowl matchup is the 5-seed Bills and the 7-seed Philadelphia Eagles, who eked out a 1-point win in a bird matchup. Jesus, this run for the Eagles through the 1, the 2, and the 3-seed on their way to the Super Bowl, the team that ended our playoff hopes a year ago. That is going to be one hell of a game. Before we do the playoff prediction, the Super Bowl predictions, we are going to look at the yearly awards. All right, so hopefully the Bears have a few players here in the yearly awards. MVP goes to Dak Prescott. Caleb Williams finishes ninth in there. Coach of the Year goes to Mike McCarthy. And for the first time, CM Punk is in the running, kind of. Finishes ninth in Coach of the Year. Offensive Player of the Year goes to Dak Prescott, the MVP. Caleb Williams finishes 10th. Defensive Player of the Year, no Bears. Still got to get a little bit better. Offensive Rookie of the Year, damn it, Trevor Etienne. I can't believe I let him slip through the cracks because I didn't want to give up picks. And then look at what we got. We released three of our draft picks before they even played a game for us. The tight end, Matt Sawyer, does finish 10th. Defensive Rookie of the Year, I don't think we're going to have anybody. We didn't really have any stud rookies on defense. Outside of Chris Jenkins, but not a good rookie season, apparently. Best quarterback, Dak Prescott. Caleb Williams finishes 6th. Best running back. Oh, really? No Bears. No Tyjae Spears at all. Best wide receiver. Do we have anybody? Malik Nabers. The only one in the running. Huh. Well, that is interesting. I knew that Cole Kmet was actually our leading receiver. So I guess that's not all that shocking, but Malik Nabers in there. That's nice. Offensive lineman, we win best OL with Tevin Jenkins. And Nate Davis finishes 3rd. So, and that's the... We just moved him to left guard. He was starting at right guard. So that decision turned out to be a good one. Best defensive line, no Bears. Our defensive line is still just... It's probably the weak spot on this team is the defensive line. Linebackers... Jermaine Edmonds, 9th. He's too good a player to be down there. God damn it. Defensive backs. No Bears, really. With as many good defensive backs as Bears team has, it's kind of surprising. Best kicker goes to Lane McKillop. Who the hell is that? Michigan alum Jake Moody finishes 2nd. Gets a gold blue. Joshua Cardy all the way down in 10th. and Cameron Dicker. It was between Dicker and Cardi as to who was going to be our kicker this year. We let Dicker go, and he finishes above Josh McCarty in the rankings. So we're back at the playoff screen for our Super Bowl prediction. We are 2-0 on Super Bowl predictions so far in this franchise, so hopefully we can continue that trend. If this was against any other team, I might go against the Eagles, but I think they finish off their immaculate run as a 7 seed and beat the Buffalo Bills. Their wins have just been that last win just barely squeaking by the Falcons, but the Falcons simulate incredibly well. I think the Philadelphia Eagles win the Super Bowl. Ha-ha! Make it 3-0 on Super Bowl predictions in this franchise when I hadn't gotten one right in either of the previous two. A 38-22 win for the Philadelphia Eagles. They're a two-time Super Bowl champion, and Jalen Hurts is Super Bowl MVP. Has it been all quarterbacks? Brock Purdy, Dak Prescott, yeah, and Jalen Hurts. This game finally becoming a little bit more realistic. So far in Madden 24, it's really love to give Super Bowl MVP to a defensive player, but that just doesn't happen very often. So we'll take a look at the retirements. I don't know what we're expecting here. For the Bears, probably not much, outside of maybe Zeke Elliott, even though he never played it down for us. Jadeveon Clowney, that's an early retirement for Clowney, actually. Tyron Smith, that's a big hit to the Detroit Lions. Wow, that's kind of shocking. I mean, not really, 15 years in the NFL, but he was still a 90 overall. So, I mean, I don't know if he played in the divisional round, but he left the wild card round early. So, I don't know, career-ending injury? Who knows? Kyle Juszczyk, former Lion Darius Slay. 14-year kicker Greg Zuerlein. Michael Thomas retires with the Bucks. Joel Bitonio, so we lose a good guard in this game. Morstead and Russell Wilson after 14 seasons retires. So the Broncos free of that awful contract. Bears getting a few retirements. OBJ retires. We brought him back there at the end, but maybe it's a possibility that since they weren't on the roster, that we just signed him as free agents and they aren't playoff roster eligible. So OBJ retires after 13 years. Bobby Wagner, he did play. Fletcher Cox played a little bit. Oh, wow. Oh, wow. Oh. Okay, so Ryan Jensen's the big loss. So now we have a hole at center completely because both of the centers we had on the roster have retired. As well as left guard AJ Cann, he was a backup. Our starting offensive line holds together decently well outside of center, but now we got to find another center. And I thought we had re-signed Jensen. I was worried about that. In terms of free agents, Eric Rowe, who we had for a season, retires. Justin Pugh as well. Eric Fisher, Ryan Tannehill, a whole bunch of Bears that we had in the 2024 season retire. Cordarrelle Patterson, we had him too. Jesus. LaMarcus Joyner. Jermaine Ifedi. Latavius Murray. All right. Interesting. So Jamie Rodriguez, it was nice knowing you. We will fire Jamie Rodriguez. And the game froze for a second. And we'll hire an offensive coordinator. Got to make sure to do this now. Otherwise, we might miss out on guys we want. Eberflus is still sitting here. Dennis Allen, Sean Payton, Kevin Stefanski, Brian Daboll. And there is Sean McVay. We could also go after Todd Bowles. I mean, not like we're really hurting for staff points, but Todd Bowles gives us double the staff points that McVay does. But McVay already has talent, so. Yeah, Frank Reich. There's a lot of real coaches here. But I think we hire Sean McVay. Because in theory, he should be our offensive coordinator. He could be the offensive coordinator of this entire franchise. So it's head coach CM Punk, offensive coordinator Sean McVay, defensive coordinator D'Amico Ryans moving forward. All right, well, mock draft. Let's see where, after our wild card playoff loss, we fall. Arch Manning going ninth to the Titans would certainly be interesting. It'd be nice because that way he's out of the NFC. And still, where does Malachi Nelson go? To the Saints. There's a chance that changes. I really kind of don't want him going to the Saints, but I don't know if we're going to be able to move up. We pick 22nd as things stand. And it seems kind of silly to try and move up in the draft just to make sure that a quarterback doesn't go to the NFC. At least he's not in our division. We are, we really need to work on the defensive line in this offseason. So if we're going to trade up, we're certainly not going to trade up and take Malachi Nelson. The player's ready to negotiate. We let DJ Moore sit here all year. I mean, what's his catch rating? Because, man, it felt like he had some big drops in this game. 93, catch in traffic 92. Spectacular catch 91, 94 speed. I mean, I hate to let this go. We're looking at $36 million in cap room right now. This would take us down to 18, which basically just shuts off everything we're able to do. So I think we let DJ Moore go to free agency. He's going to sign somewhere else, obviously, but he is going to be 30 years old. And we have three good young receivers that can get us by through the season. And we can even add a fourth on a bit of a cheaper deal. We don't need – Emeka Ibuka is nearly at DJ Moore territory already. So we can let Moore go. Darnell Wright at right tackle. This is an option, so we don't have to worry about that. Frank Gore Jr., Dominique Robinson. I think DJ Moore is really the only one that we should consider re-signing, but I don't think we're gonna. What happens if we offer him like a team-friendly offer? It only saves us about $1 million in cap as opposed to what it otherwise would. I'm gonna honestly throw a pretty insulting offer at him. Just on the off chance that interest is enough to re-sign. Salary of 5.5 and a bonus of 5.5 for 3 years. Yeah, I figured. He actually wasn't as offended as I thought. But let's see. Teams are interested in Sam Howell. We don't need to go after a backup quarterback. James Cook, not what we need. Having an Alvin Kamara would be nice. We'll keep our eye on that one. Receiver, obviously DJ Moore is the top receiver here. After that, it falls off. Rondale Moore might not be a bad one to look at. All fine at tight end. Let's just skip up to center. And it's not great, but it could be worse. Probably just try and get an offer in on Andre James. He's the younger of the two centers here. Actually, or does Ryan Kelly not even want a signing bonus? No, he does. Of course he does. But that's another one that we're just going to sign and immediately is going to retire. We could, in theory, move a guard, but it's a dicey thing to do to just sign an offensive lineman, move him over to center, and think they're going to be okay. Some are good, some aren't so great. I mean, we'd almost have to sign Joe Thuney. Unfortunately, Tyler Smith has no interest in us at all. That would be nice to have a 25-year-old to move over to center. All right, well, we need one. Whether or not we make another move for a center, that will... Actually, Andre James wants a little bit of a cheaper deal, so we can go player-friendly on that. And might even have the top offer. Ooh, we're tied with the Pats. Thankfully, though, his interest is high, so we got that going for us. Defensive tackle. We actually have a couple good ones. Tyre Tart is the one we should target immediately. Maybe make a trade for another one. Try a neutral offer on Tart to start out. Tied with the Seahawks. It's going to be nice, but that would make our... Remember, actually, we only need one defensive tackle. So keep that in mind. Grady Jarrett could also move over to DT. $12.8 a year. $12.2. It's not a big fall off. Bryce Huff. That's a defensive end. But Grady Jarrett could easily move over to defensive tackle. Outside linebackers. This is not great. Might have to go after Matt Judon. What are we looking at right outside linebackers to move over? Van Ginkle. David Ajabo. I kind of forget that left outside linebacker is just a position that is always kind of around this 80 overall mark. If you get him over 80 overall, it's usually pretty rare. So maybe we're not as bad off as I thought. Let's take one last look at what we're looking at for outside linebackers. Or maybe even this is the year that we move Noah Sewell to outside linebacker. Jack Sanborn's a 77. That's not that bad. Just because TJ Edwards is really good doesn't take away from the fact that, I mean, like I said, I mean, outside linebackers just don't get very high overall in this game, so... If we went into the season with Jack Sanborn, that's not a terrible thing. And we do have an aging Shaq Leonard. And then if we move Noah Sewell, who's up to a 75 overall at middle linebacker, if we move him to, say, left outside linebacker, what happens? He's a 77. And I like the plays that Noah Sewell made, man. Really, really nice. I'd like to have him on the field more. Which means we could just trade Jack Sanborn. Let's explore that. He had one nice game for us and not much else. He's got an $8.7 million cap hit. We're not going to get much back in a trade. In fact, not much at all. And we don't need any of this. This Sean Murphy is kind of intriguing. 22. Some good depth for us. Save us some cap space and allow us to do a little bit more. So then we're good here in theory. Good there. So as long as we sign the center and that defensive tackle, we're going to be pretty much set with our starters. pretty much set. So now what does that do for cap room? We have $36 million in cap. No, we don't. We have $15 million. What the hell? Maybe that's not off the books yet, dude. I don't know. DJ Moore, Rondale Moore. We could just draft a wide receiver that could probably be just a little bit worse than these guys. That's signing DJ Reader put his negative cap somehow. Honestly, if we sign those two guys, I mean, we addressed our left outside linebacker need internally. I don't know why it says we got $36 million here and then we don't. But let's simulate a week, see if we get those guys. We got 38 players on the roster now, so let's hope for the best. All right, so they both signed. So we got a center and another defensive tackle. That's good. We got the new mock draft out. Any changes? Arch Manning still to the Titans. Malachi Nelson still to the Saints, unfortunately. We are not taking a corner. We're going to throw this off. Unfortunately for us, these drafts usually kind of go very similarly to how this mock draft plays it out. We could trade up potentially for a guy like Carnell Tate or Rocco Mason. Not very fast there for Mason. What about Marquee Hunt? Three or 4-3 speed. I think we have our target. A 4-3-1, no less. Marquee Hunt. So we'd have to trade up two picks to a division rival. So that may get expensive. But we'll see what happens. But I think we're good in terms of our free agency moves. We got all of our starters kind of figured out. Let's just simulate up to the draft. But let's start the 2026 NFL draft. We are looking to trade up with the Green Bay Packers. And let's not waste any time. Because we want that receiver. How are we, Lewis? Lucas, Jesus Christ. Trade center, trade finder. 22nd pick. We're going to try and send this to the Packers. For pick number 20. If it goes before that, this receiver we want, then we got some issues. But we will trade up. Just two spots. Hopefully it's not going to cost us much. You were having one hell of a season in fantasy. We have a first, second, third, two fifths, three sixths, two sevenths in this year's draft. We have 2 seconds next year. I'm thinking if we throw on a second, I want it to be next year where we have two of them. It's to not screw up our draft too much. I'm going to start with offering them the first and this third. Given that it is only two spots we're trying to move up here. Let's see if it works. It does. That is good. So we didn't even have to give up a second. That is big. All right. So we can start the draft. We're going to simulate these picks individually. And reminder, the name we don't want to see on the screen is Marquee Hunt. Deep threat, fastest receiver in the draft, elite acceleration, elite agility, elite speed. Might even replace Kobe Prentice at kick returner if his speed is really as good as we think it may be with this fucking 4-3-1. So Marquise Hunt is the name we do not want to see come off that board. But thankfully, he's the fourth wide receiver listed, and I don't think the other teams are really thinking about him right now. So the first pick in the draft, the Los Angeles Rams, Zachariah Branch, best receiver in the draft. So one receiver already off the board, but we kind of figured that was going to happen. Skip ahead again. Left tackle, Caden Proctor. Defensive end, Keon Keeley. Defensive tackle, Jordan Hall, would be nice to have, but we probably don't want to give up what it would have taken to move up to get him. Cornerback, Desmond Hicks. Running back, Dylan Edwards, always simulates well. Safety, Alex Lauderdale, not great to see him in the division. He simulates good as well. Casey Newton, left tackle. Arch Manning to the Titans, we knew that was happening. Means Malachi Nelson, unless things switch up, probably going to be a New Orleans Saint. Another defensive end. Adebo Ware off the board. Right tackle, Wayne McFarland. I'm never drafting him again. David Horn, another nice player that really could have helped us out. However, I don't want to give up too much in a trade. So David Horn goes 12. Marcus Peppers, defensive end out of Notre Dame. Carnell Tate, another receiver. We got to make it five more picks with Marquise Hunt still on the board. Tyrell Carrington goes. Rocco Mason. This should be the Malachi Nelson pick, in theory. Oh, wow. They didn't take Malachi Nelson. They went against the mock draft and they take a defensive end. If he falls to me, I don't have a choice. I really don't. I don't think he's going to make it two more picks. There's no way, especially with the Steelers still rocking Kenny Pickett. They took a tight end. Oh my God. This might be a we just can't let this go scenario. What in the hell? The Jacksonville Jaguars still have T-Law. They're not going to take a quarterback, are they? They took a safety. What in the hell? What are they not seeing? He's got A's in everything. A awareness, A play action, A deep accuracy, A medium accuracy, A short accuracy, A throw on the run, A throw under pressure. Those are all for sure things. The value is just too much to pass up. We don't need Malachi Nelson. But now we can send him wherever the hell we want. He's not going to unseat Caleb Williams. Caleb Williams is going to be our guy. But with the value here, we're going to be able to trade Nelson probably after year one and have a really good backup for this next year. So if anything happens to Caleb Williams again, Malachi Nelson's just here. How the hell did he fall to us? A's in everything. He's going to be hidden dev. We know that. I'm fairly certain he's superstar. I mean, it's a no-brainer. Malachi Nelson is a Chicago Bear for now. Maybe we just waste his career as the backup to the Bears. But this is an ace in the hole for us. I can't believe he fell. I can't believe the Saints didn't take him. Who is the Saints quarterback? Did they sign somebody that threw that off? I mean, there's no way. They have Trey Lance and Sam Hartman. Look at these receivers, and they got that quarterback. Oh, no. New Orleans. How do you fumble that? I cannot believe that Malachi Nelson fell to us. That is actually stunning. And like I said, we don't need him. But now this is the quarterbacks are valued so highly in this game. We have a huge piece to trade if we want. We could trade Caleb Williams if we wanted to now. That's not my plan. The plan is to get rid of Nelson at some point. But my goodness, how does this happen? Falls to 20. It's just like when we took Arch Manning with Cleveland. Unbelievable. Well, we're going to miss out on that receiver unless he falls too. If he falls all the way to pick 22 in the second round, something's wrong. This draft cannot work out like that. It did not. But that's fine. So let's look at best available here. I see corners. I see receivers. How are we looking at Christian Woods? Slow as hell. So we don't need to add that. I did want to add another receiver. Sean Duvall. I've drafted him before. Nothing elite here. In a perfect world, I want a defensive tackle, but there aren't any. Oh, boy. This is not great. I've drafted Evan Young before. Or at least signed him. He turns out okay. Let's see what trade offers there might just be for this late second round pick. In a perfect world, we get picks next year. No way anyone's offering us a first rounder. And they're not. So we're in the 2025 draft. We get a second and a fifth next year from Baltimore. These are all next year. I know the Raiders offered five. I didn't take a good look at that one yet. I like this Atlanta deal so far. Green Bay. Bit concerning that they want to give up four picks. Don't want to help them out. So Green Bay is offering us a second 2 years from now. Or sorry, Las Vegas. 2 years from now. But four picks for next year's draft. 2 sevenths, though. And I mean, the majority of this trade is, you know, late round picks. I mean, it would let us spread out the love on the draft picks a little bit. We don't need them all next year. Second, fifth, and a seventh. I mean, this is a lot of picks. This feels like it's the most picks that anyone's offering us. A second and a fourth. What was Green Bay sending? A second and a third. I really don't want to trade with Green Bay, though, because they're worrying me wanting to trade up to this spot. We definitely don't want to help Green Bay out in any way, shape, or form. And you can still find really good players. in the second round. If the Raiders find a gem at this spot, more power to them. That shouldn't affect us unless we face them in the Super Bowl. So we are going to take the Raiders' offer, get a slew of draft picks that I really did not expect us to get. And the way the Bears' trajectory is going, that should essentially be a move up in the draft. So let's see who the Raiders wanted so badly. Tight end. A tight end, Calvin Easley. Do they not have Michael Mayer? They do, but outside of that, it ain't great. All right, what are their receivers looking like? Adams, Myers, Worthy, Renfro, Trey Tucker. They're okay. Quarterback is Penix still. I don't know if that's worth a tight end, man. All right, well, that's our second round done. Round three, pick 22. Not a single... Oh, wait. Oh, no. Have I made a mistake? I think I took four picks this year. Oh, well. I mean, it's fine. There was nobody we desperately wanted. Anyway. Cole Tiller might be a good option here. Anything elite? Ooh. Elite acceleration, elite agility, and nothing bad. Cole Tiller looks really nice. And apparently now we have plenty of chances to take shots at these players. C tackle's a little rough. Hopefully we can improve on that. Cole Tiller. E. Okay. Consider that a miss. Yeah, I definitely think I messed up and forgot what year this draft was. We have a ton of draft picks now. Holy hell, if that is the case. It sure... Oh, no! Look at all those picks! No! That's not great. Hey, a catching, though, on this Darvian White. Deep route running is an F. Okay. All right. Nothing great there. I did want a receiver at some point. Caleb Palmer. Nothing that says, hey, draft me. It's all wide receivers at the top of the board. Do not need no introduction. Corners. A defensive end, Kurt Tracy. Poor agility, poor speed. I mean, I don't know. Let's just try and take a shot at the best defensive tackle we can find, which might be Damian Bushrod. C's and A to C on tackling. It's a whole lot better than that. Will these Bears be unbearable to face? Who knows? What are we looking at for the weight on this guy? 304? It's good. Is there a defensive tackle that's just absolutely massive? The highest I saw was 320. Well, we haven't been unbearable to face just yet. We are just kind of floundering at finding anything good, really, in this draft. It's not a very good draft. I mean, Tevin Battles, 291. We could move him to defensive tackle if he's all right. Poor agility, poor speed, but he's a defensive tackle. So as long as he's big and gets in the way, run stopping DT being on the smaller end for defensive tackles and having poor agility is not great. B tackle, F finesse moves. All right. Jesus. Don't really want to draft anyone with Fs. James Chancellor. Well, that's projected undrafted. This draft is going to take an eternity. I fucked that up. Bad. I really thought we were in the 2025 draft for some reason. Might trade away some of those picks for picks next year. Because this is not... There's nothing jumping out at me here. Do you have a free safety and a lot... Alfonso Tate, B power, but D man coverage, D zone coverage. A power, B tackle for this safety, but also projected undrafted. Fullbacks? B to D, Seth Caldwell, 261. It's a beefy fullback. But not grades, and that's even not good grades, and that's, you know, curve to tell you that they're a fullback here. Man, I don't know. Let's just go offensive line. Raekwon Hines. Normal, but we kind of expected that. Might be able to fill out our depth just with draft picks alone. Pick 18. Let's trade this one for a draft pick next year. A 2028 and a 2027. Nothing higher than a fifth. We didn't expect that. Two picks in 2028 and a pick in 2027. We could absolutely kill the Raiders draft, trade with them for a second time, but let's trade with the Rams. We do not need all these picks. Especially when we have a pick four picks away. Just get a haul for later on. CCDD for this corner. Man to man. Everything's solid. Good speed, strength, marginal. He's a corner. But he's... Oh my God. Look who it is. Greg Gray, the Cleveland Browns legend, is here. Does it give us a grade on his kick return? No. But given that we've drafted Greg Gray before, he was the one that just had kickoff return after kickoff return for touchdowns with the Cleveland Browns. Greg Gray, welcome back. 91 speed. Do we have a kick return? Kick return A. Yeah, there we go. Welcome back, Greg Gray. We have like three returners on this team now. But I think Greg Gray's rating is going to be the highest of any of them. Outside of maybe Emeka Ibuka, and that's not a chance I want to take. Let's just draft the first... Okay, maybe not the first player with a safety with F tackling. D block shed, C power move for this defensive tackle. Byron Weber. We've got so many chances. We have five six-round picks. Let's just take a shot at Byron Weber. 90 strength is good. 304 defensive tackle out of Buffalo. Power rusher. So we skip ahead two picks, do this again. We'll be here a while. I got to take a short break here in about 15 minutes. B Blockshed C Pursuit for this outside linebacker. Never a bad thing to have young guys here. Ooh. Elite acceleration. Yet he's really slow. But quick on the jump, I guess. So, Brandon Turnage? This doesn't feel like a draft that we're going to find any sneaky... sneaky, like, hidden dev guys in. I don't know. It doesn't appear that that's going to be the case. Just a lot of D's, a lot of C's. We could take a shot at this safety, Chris Stevenson. B to D tackle, B hit power. Speed is good. I don't think we've taken a safety this entire draft. 89 speed, 84 acceleration. Good enough. And you never know. We can get breakouts on these guys and up their dev tree. It's always a possibility. Well, we'll continue on with a draft in which I have no idea what to do. We still have... Oh, my God. 4 seventh-round picks. Oh, no. And all we're doing is taking shots in the dark now. Imagine being late during a draft. Well, you know. We've taken this Tevin Swede before, haven't we? He's got a couple A's, C carrying. Didn't we try and move him to fullback or something? A ball carrier vision, A break tackle, C carrying, catching C to F. Maybe we didn't draft him. I don't know what the deal is with Tevin Swede. Let's take Tevin Swede and maybe manage him a bit better this time. I don't know if I would have moved this to fullback. 89 speed, 88 acceleration. We're not very good at the late round hidden devs in this draft. So now the first of our 4 seventh rounders. Not what we wanted. I don't know really what position to get. Usually when, you know, we have like insane amounts of picks in the seventh round, I'd do something stupid like take fullbacks, take kickers, take punters, take quarterbacks that are never going to play a snap for us. But we're good at all those positions, so I really don't know what to do. Other than maybe just look for some good grades here. Vince Samuel, A throw power, but this is, again, this is a quarterback that we really don't need now that we got Malachi Nelson. David Atkinson, we've already made that mistake once. He never grew into anything for the Raiders. Not going to do that again. All quarterbacks down here. And that's the top 50 players. I mean, we could take a shot at a fullback and maybe he's a tight end. Maybe he's a tight end. But all these fullbacks, we don't know what their catch rating is. It's anywhere from B to D, or in the case of Chris Eaton here, C to F. Marquise Dunnell we have drafted before. Is there any shockingly big quarterbacks? I mean, David Atkinson's 244. Probably not, because that's why I took Atkinson in the first place. Skittery little running back, maybe? A catching for this Dwayne Richardson. C carrying. It's almost like this guy'd be... make Atkinson a fullback. Are you ready for a 12 overall fullback? Because that's what he's about to be. Second fastest running back here. I'm going to be interested to see. Yes, that high, I think, because I think 12 is the lowest it goes. I'm going to be interested to see about potentially moving Dwayne Richardson here to wide receiver. He's 5'10". So that's not ideal. But if he's got catching above, like, 80, it is a possibility for us. So Dwayne Richardson, 88 speed. C carrying, but A catching. A to C medium route. Okay. Well, we'll see what happens. We don't know anything about if that can even work yet. So now, still three more picks. I was upset that the David Atkinson experiment didn't work. Center. These guys are all ass. Ooh. A, impact blocking. C, run block. 342. That is a big right guard. His jumping is poor, but who cares? He's an offensive lineman. He's also the fastest right guard in the draft at a 5-second 40. C, run block. Yeah, look at this. I mean, the power isn't going to be good for some reason. You'd think it would be at that height and weight, but apparently not. Daryl Pinner. 90 strength. I know he doesn't look like a 342-pounder quite yet, but we'll fix him up good. Yeah, right? He just weighs 342 pounds for no reason. Doesn't use it. Do we have the Mr. Irrelevant pick? No, we have the one before it. Alright, well, we found some good pieces this late in the draft. Siante Shepherd, a defensive end out of Arizona State. That's just a lot of C's, which is not bad. 314, this guy's a defensive tackle. Poor agility is not what we like to see. Yeah, there's some depth down here, shockingly enough. All right. We haven't really looked at the needs of our team much because we really don't have that many. But left outside linebacker, or outside linebacker in general, is a position of need. If you can call it that. I mean, we're good there, but we're not great. There's only these five guys, and we don't know much about him. So let's go to the left side. I think taking a chance on this James Chancellor isn't a terrible idea. There's a lot of notes for this guy. Only thing a little bit worrisome is marginal strength, but I think we take James Chancellor. There's no downside to it, really, at this point. It's a good thing we're not in owner mode anymore, because the signing bonuses on these draft picks would probably put us in debt. And 2026, 2027 is usually about when that would happen. So what do you say we trade for the Mr. Irrelevant pick? Trade back one spot in the draft. Really? The Eagles don't want to trade? I'll make you trade. Not an offer. You think we could trade that? No, we can't select it. Oh, we can't select any draft picks. I was going to be like, can we just trade a first-round pick that we've already made? No. So what we have to do is go to the Eagles. This is a lot of effort for just a stupid thing that I enjoy doing, but... Wait, can we not select picks here either? Oh, I'm in the roster. I'm so stupid. Gotta go to the trade center. Alright, to Philly. Seventh round, pick 224. For our seventh round, pick 223. Didn't think there was going to be any issue there. So who does Philly take now? A wide receiver. All right, so who is going to be... Are there any meme players? Any meme players? As of yet, no. Yep, this last pick is just a roll of the dice. It's about all we can do. Short accuracy of A on this late round quarterback, Joe Holiday. Throw power of F. I don't know if I've ever seen a quarterback in this game have a throw power of F. What's the number of players? At this point, I have no clue. There's only 50 on this screen. Another short accuracy. Throw power. Oh, no. Wait, that's throw under pressure. Player 38. Are they numbered? They are. Player 38. Or player 35. I suppose it's Evo's idea. I'll go 35. Cornerback. Lavon Morse. Out of Western. Western Michigan. What are we getting? That's actually good speed. 447 in his 40-yard dash, the combine. Whoever has the better name, whoever has the better stats. All right, good point. So we got Lavon Morse here, or Joe Holiday. Damn it. Throw under pressure is the F. I lied. His throw power... is not listed. I mean, A, short accuracy, B, play action. There's no guarantee that he stays on the... Well, there's no guarantee either one of these players stay on the roster. I mean, none of the names are really kind of funny, but we did have a good laugh at the F, even though I mistook it for what it meant. But an F throw under pressure is still terrible. A Northwestern quarterback. This is going to be the fourth quarterback on our roster, so some people are going to go. So his throw power is actually 88, but that's still not good. Acceleration's an 86, but his speed's a 74. Yeah, I don't know what to do with that, but there's Mr. Irrelevant, Joe Holiday. Oh, I should have looked at the draft recap. Well, anyway, let's just head to our roster. We're not going to go any further in Bears today. We've got a Stanley Cup Final Game 6, yes, to play. Against the Minnesota Wild. That'll be the last thing we do today. Caleb Williams, still the quarterback heading into this season. But look at Malachi Nelson. A player that we couldn't pass up. I couldn't believe he fell to us at 20. He's got to be superstar dev with an 80 overall starting overall here. That's insane. He's probably going to be our backup quarterback for this season. We're going to let Josh Dobbs go. Yeah, I know. The mock draft said he was going to the Saints a couple picks before that, and then he fell, and I'm just like, I can't not take him. And I had toyed with the idea of trading up for him anyway to make sure he didn't go to the NFC. And we didn't even have, we did trade up, but it was to draft a receiver. That didn't go according to plan, but it honestly worked out better. So there's a lot of value here in Malachi Nelson. So he's going to be our backup ahead of this season. And then when Caleb Williams is up for a contract in three seasons, I want to say, we're going to have some decisions to make.